this team from where we were last year to where we're trying to go for this upcoming season. And I think it's great to have a chance to go to Europe, not only use it as an educational trip, which in my opinion, some of the best education is in travel. And you go to a place like France and Greece, you get a chance to really explore and learn a lot about the cultures. But then we also get an opportunity to play three games, which I feel is a wonderful opportunity for our guys to get a chance to measure where we are at this moment and in time of our team, and seeing what areas we can improve on as we look forward to this upcoming season.
What would you tell the football team this week?
That's a situation of brotherhood where you have an amazing coach, Coach Harbaugh, and his staff, and all the hard work they put in this summer leading up to where they are now, and I'm sure where their goals as far as where they're trying to go with the team. Knowing that, I'm sure the end goal is championship. And that's what we all try to compete for and win. But it's nice to see a great staff and players bought into the staff and seeing that connection. And I've always been one of those people that have been a big fan of football and a huge fan of the Michigan football.
Back to the exhibition games, I guess how will you treat them? They're exhibition, they don't count, but there's a scoreboard and you're competitive, I guess, as far as how many guys play and things like that.
Yeah, everyone will get a chance to play. And that's what's the beauty of this summer is we've been working hard. Guys have been put in a time, whether it's on their own, when we're not allowed to be together as a team, or when we are together as a team, seeing whether it's being in the weight room, getting stronger and faster, whether it's getting in the gym or getting their extra work on their own. But then when they're with us, developing what is asked of them, what their roles will be. But it's nice to see them this summer, with all the different lineups that I'm gonna throw at, different rotations and everyone getting a chance to play, I can see what this team will look like hopefully as we come back from those three-game trip. But then, as we have September to get a little, 4-hour work in per week before we have our first practice.
Do you know anything about these teams that you're playing or what they are or who they are?
I know some team. I know our first team that we play in France. And I do not want to say their name and mispronounce it, but I will say this. I know they have four players that play in the NBA, and I think that is great. It's great to get a chance to play against experienced guys that are professional men, which pretty much in college we faced last season, it was the collegiate level, but a lot of older men being a young team that we had last year. But I'm sure you guys know this by looking at our roster, we have a lot of younger guys this year too, five incoming freshmen. But I think that's why this summer is a very critical time for us to add to our culture. What our culture is family being first. And when you're away from your main family members that you spent your lives with, and you get a chance to be with guys that you call your extended family, your brothers, for 10 days, I think this is the best bonding you can ever get.
How many players can you work with together in the summer? Oh, is it only with individual players, or can you work with two or three together at a time?
Well, thank God we passed those COVID restrictions that we had before. The last 2 years, we were limited as far as how many guys we had in the gym at one time. Now that we've progressed, in the second, I don't know what phase of COVID this is, but we're still dealing with COVID, but we're able to have our entire team recorded at one time. But unfortunately, we haven't had Yusuf here. But I will tell you this, that Yusuf will be joining us very soon. Very soon.
Will he be there in Europe with you?
Sorry?
Will he be in Europe with you? Will he meet you
yes.
there? Great.
Yes. Well, you said meet him there.
Yeah.
I said he can join us very soon.
I see. You talked about culture. Can you talk about the young guys, what that you see as culture fits in his ball players, the new kids that you brought in?
Well, you know, when we identify a recruiting, you know, yes, we're looking at, you know, a skill set and, you know, how they, you know, present themselves from a skill level standpoint, but I also look at, you know, the character piece, which is huge for me. The character extends as far as, you know, academics as well as their family, because I don't just recruit the player, I recruit the families too. And each guy has been chosen. And they have committed to buying into the culture, because the culture has been explained to them before they step foot on campus. So you have a choice. And you bought in from the beginning, you signed up for this. Now it's time to get uncomfortable.
What kind of a player do you think you have in Yusuf, and how did he sort of come on your radar? What kind of interactions did you have with him in the process?
Yes, Yusuf is very dynamic. Bigger wing, and I say bigger because he's like 6'9"-ish, close to almost 6'10", and very athletic for shoot the ball from the outside, stretch. You can play him in multiple positions because of his versatility. If I said athletic, you know, athletics, I'm like excited about the athleticism if I say it again. But he also high IQ player too. I think that's very valuable. You know, you have a guy who, you didn't get a chance to watch him in person, but the tape, and I mean by tape, let me be specific, you know, I watch games. You know, I just watch highlights because, man, shit, you can come up with highlight tapes, okay, not. But like, I watch games, and games, it gives me an idea of like what type of player he really is. I started recruiting him when Caleb and Musa decided to keep his name in the draft, and knowing that we would have two available scholarships right away, I identified that Yusuf was our guy who fits, and all hands on deck when I went to recruit him. And we were behind, which was fine, you know, that's how it goes sometimes. See a guy that can be a huge, valuable part of his group and team that is just all in.
What kind of sense do you have for maybe how ready he would be to play at this level relative to like a Musa and Caleb who played big minutes as freshmen?
Well, we haven't had him practice yet, but I would say this, that, you know, what he presents from a skill level at, I just touched on earlier, that we need him. We need him. It's a difference between need and want.
Sure.
You know, want is like, well, we want everything in life. You know, you need something, that's a big difference in my, that's how I identify. That's my definition.
You mentioned that this is a young team. In terms of the limited time that you've had with the guys so far, has anyone stepped up into more of a leadership role this year that wasn't last year?
Well, just, I mean, the obvious is, you know, Mr. Hunter. You know, he's really stepped up and taken on that more of a leadership role, and that's leadership as far as being vocal, and also leadership when it comes to how he goes about his work. And that work involves with how he, when he steps foot in this gym, he's dialed into getting better. He comes in and works hard. He wants to add more to his game to prove that he's improved each year. And each year he has added more to his game. And that's what, like, I've been so impressed with Hunter. You know, the first year as a freshman, you know, when he got his opportunity, he came in and delivered, you know, off the bench. Improving, play with back to the basket. And then when he got to start lineup, you know, he just took off from there, and he got more comfortable, more confident with himself. Always had a basketball mind. Second year he came in, he wanted to stretch the floor out, face a big, you know, show that he could add outside shooting for the team, and he put the work in. And, you know, he's one of our guys who can score inside and outside. And that's extending all the way from to the three-point line. This year, stronger, leaner, quicker, and more lateral quickness, explosive jumping, higher motor. I mean, that, those are the things that you have to admire and respect. And as a teammate, when you see a guy like that is, you know, getting himself uncomfortable, and, but is doing it for the level to help his team to be a winning team, you know, everyone else can follow suit. And it doesn't mean they're doing the same thing, they're just, you know, making sure that they are doing their part as far as holding up their end of the market.